Today we are going to be making some gluten-free, grain-free, high-protein pizza crust and pizza. And I'm going to show you guys how to make your pizza healthy, quick, and it won't sit on top of your abs like normal pizza does. Hopefully you've already watched the 10 reasons to stop eating wheat video, which I'll put a link to right here. Hopefully you guys are on the bandwagon with me on not eating wheat. And if you are, I'm sure that you have seen phenomenal results. I'm sure that your body is changing in major, major ways. And I'm also sure that you're craving pizza because if you're not, you're not a human being. And let's just go ahead and get right into it. It's gonna be super quick, super easy. We're gonna start with the crust. The main one is coconut flour. Coconut flour is made of coconuts, that's it. The ingredients on coconut flour, it's organic coconut. No wheat, no gluten, no grain, nothing. The nutritional information on coconut flour is very impressive. 2 grams of fat, 8 grams of carbohydrates, 5 of them are fiber, 2 grams of protein. And that's for 2 tablespoons. We're gonna be using a third of a cup of flaxseed meal. Flaxseed meal is ground up flax seeds. If you guys aren't familiar with flax seeds are a very, very great source of omega-3 fatty acids. These are going to also lend a rich, delicious flavor to the crust, and it's also going to satisfy you because it's fiber full. We're gonna go ahead and add a third of a cup of flax. Almond flour, this is ground up almonds. That's it, ground up almonds. If you look on the ingredients of those frozen pizzas, even the healthy ones from various health food brands, I'm not gonna call anybody out, but the ingredient list for the crust of a pizza is just a mile long. This pizza crust is so simple and so healthy. Enough rambling, Brenda, sorry. Once I get going, you can't stop me. 2 tablespoons of almond flour, 2 heaping tablespoons. I'm not a big fan of thick crust, so I'm going for a thin crust. The almond flour is gonna help make it crispy and delicious. I'm gonna add 2 whole eggs. I'm gonna also do 2 whites. You can also just do egg whites. That's gonna up the protein content of the pizza crust. So now you need a fork, and with the fork, you're just gonna mix everything in together. And eventually, you're gonna see it's all gonna start to bind. And make sure that you get the edges, and you just kind of keep working it in there, and eventually it'll all glue together into kind of a ball. You're gonna then pick it up and you're gonna kind of just play with it a little bit. And if your crust isn't what you want it to be, if it's still kind of runny, or if it's still kind of not gluing together, or if it's still kind of like wet and hard to handle, you just add a touch more of the coconut flour. Mine is looking pretty good, so I'm going to massage it into a ball. I've got a pizza pan here, a 12-inch pizza pan, but you don't need this. You could use whatever pan that you have, so don't feel like you can't do the recipe if you don't have a certain pan. The very important thing I want you to do is take your coconut oil, unrefined organic coconut oil if you can get it. Side note, coconut oil should smell good. If it doesn't have a smell to it, that means that it's no good. So you're gonna take tiny knob of coconut oil in your hands, and you're gonna grease your pan with your coconut oil. That was about, I don't know, a half a teaspoon. Otherwise, it's gonna stick to the pan and give you a whole bunch of grief. Now, you're gonna throw it on your pan, and you're gonna just work it out. It just takes some eyeballing. Preheat your oven at 450 degrees. Just flatten out the edges. Make it look presentable. Once you get it all kneaded out, take your spices and spice the crust. Oregano, Celtic sea salt, so garlic powder, and basil. You can also do this when you're kneading it. Really, that's the proper way, but I forgot. Now I'm gonna pop this into the preheated oven, and we're gonna cook it for about 5 to 10 minutes, depending on the heat of your own oven. I'm basically looking for the edges to be golden and the center to be not quite done yet. Go ahead and chop up your vegetables, chop up your chicken if you're putting chicken on it. I'm not a big fan of just regular cheese because I feel like the fat is too much for my body. If you want to use regular cheese for yours, that's totally fine. When I eat just regular cheese, it just kind of sits on me. It makes me feel not so great. And so I'm going with the almond cheese and another cheese variant that I'll show you in a minute. Almond cheese is just basically protein. There's 1 gram of fat and 7 grams of protein. Now this is casein based, so it's not a dairy-free per se cheese, but I like the nutritional content much better for my body. And also this cheese melts just like normal cheese and it tastes pretty good too. You're gonna use probably about half of it. I'm just gonna use the large part of the cheese grater. For all the people who don't like dairy, for the vegans and whatnot, we've got the Daiya cheese, which is also good for those of you who are intolerant to dairy. I can do casein, I'm okay with casein, but a lot of people feel like they aren't a big fan of the casein. Casein is a little bit of a slower digesting protein, so if you're a fast oxidizer, which is metabolic typing talk for basically my body type, then you would want a slow digesting protein. You don't want a protein that's going to digest too quickly. And you can ignore everything that I just said if I'm going way out there for you, and you can just pick whatever cheese you think tastes better. So the almond cheese, regular cheese, or this Daiya vegan cheese. We gotta put the toppings on, and this is the easy and fun part. If you have children, this is the part that's going to help to get them to eat this. When they help to cook something, they are about 100% more likely to eat it. You can make your own sauce, but I feel like it's so much easier to just grab a can of tomato sauce that you like or marinara sauce that you like and just put it on the pizza. This one's called Cucina Antica. It's no sugar added. I like that it's just really simple ingredients and it tastes really, really good. I'm just gonna spoon this on here, and this is all by preference. Do you like a lot of sauce? Do you not like too much sauce? I like a moderate amount. This is just kind of a show and tell from this point, because from this point you add whatever you want onto your pizza. This is just how I like to do it. 3 cloves of garlic. I'm putting them into my garlic press, and I'm gonna press and move it as I'm pressing. I'm gonna do some spinach. Throw on this almond cheese. I'm gonna spoon just a little more of the sauce on top. For the little spots that I want to just kind of cover up, I'm just gonna throw some of this vegan cheese, a little bit of the vegan cheese. And the last thing I'm gonna add are fresh tomatoes on top. You can put it back into your oven. I just set my oven to broil, and I'm gonna put it on the bottom shelf. While the pizza's cooking, I'm gonna do what I always do, and I'm gonna have a dance party. It is done and it looks beautiful. I'm really proud of this recipe, you guys, and I think you guys are gonna love it.